Kula. Hallelujah. Amen. Someone is amen.
Amen.
Kula vinaka. We are here again in the house of the Lord. And the Bible tells us where two or three are gathered in His name, He is there in their midst. Hallelujah. And that is a joyful thing that God is here with us. Hallelujah. We are not here on our own. We are here because of Him. Hallelujah. Amen. The Bible tells us that the days we are living in are days for us to sanctify ourselves and to come before the Lord God Almighty in holiness, in purity, and in salvation. So tonight, God has brought you here because He loves you so much. He cared for you so much. I know that some of you travel from village and far places to come here tonight. God will honor you and reward you for your travels and for the things you have come, because you've come not to honor me or to honor the team from Australia, but you've come to honor the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He is all of us. Hallelujah. It is not about us, it's about Him. Hallelujah. Without Him, we are nothing. Hallelujah. So please, if you don't mind, lift up. Thank you. Lift up your hand with me. Say, Father, speak to my heart. Touch my life. In Jesus' name. Say, Father, I want to hear your word. Minister to me today. Amen. Amen. I like it when I wear my sulu. Amen. Yeah. Amen. Yeah. I love my sulu. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm a real Fijian. Amen. Yeah. Hallelujah. Amen. Yeah. Amen. Now I have to learn the language and I will speak better than Brother Paul. Amen. Hey. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. I'm going to read the scripture to you today. It's the book of 2 Peter chapter 1. I'm going to read from verse 5 to verse 11. And I'm going to speak to a lot of us today that God is putting in our heart things that, you know, we are seeing in our days and things that you got to learn for the kingdom of God. So 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 5 to verse 11. 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 5 to verse 11. I like, you see, people bringing their Bibles to church. That's beautiful. I can see Pastor here, bring your Bible, beautiful. Your Bible to church, wonderful. It is always good to bring the Bible to the house of the Lord. Amen. 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 I'm going to read now. And the Bible says here, it says, and beside this, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge, and to knowledge temperance, and to temperance patience, and to patience godliness, and to godliness brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness, charity. For if these things be in you and abound, they make you that you shall neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. But he that lacketh these things is blind and cannot see afar, and hath forgotten that he was once purged from the old sins. Wherefore, brethren, rather give diligence to make your calling and election sure. For if you do these things, you shall never fail. Somebody say, never fail. Never fail. Never fail. Never fail. Amen. 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 For an entrance shall be ministered unto you abundantly unto the everlasting kingdom of our Lord Jesus, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. 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 Now, people of God, I'm going to explain something to you today. I'm going to try and be very calm and not to, you know, get too fast, because I've asked God, help me to slow down. Yeah? Amen. Amen. Now, the Bible says, giving all diligence. First of all, let me explain what diligence means to you. A diligent man, a man that is diligent, is a man that prepares himself before the opportunity comes. Let me explain. If the Prime Minister of Fiji, what's his name again? If he's coming here to the village of Suwanee, yeah, you make a big, a big tent, you prepare the chairs and all and all and all, and then they said, we're going to sing. Now, I'm going to tell you something. They're not going to ask Pastor Timothy to come and sing, yeah? No, yeah? They won't ask Sister Lorena to sing, no? Yeah? They won't ask Pastor Veniki to sing. You know why? Because if you sing, your voice is a different one, yeah? They will look for a professional singer. They will look for a singer that has been singing for a long time, that is prepared, that knows the note. They will look for somebody that can sing so well. They will look for all the equipment. In other words, the person has been prepared before he comes. So
So a diligent person is somebody that prepares himself before the opportunity comes. Amen. 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 So what God is saying to you and I, give on diligence. In other words, prepare yourself. In other words, get yourself ready for what God is about to do. In other words, you and I, we're going to give diligence. You know what? The one thing in the Christian faith that is lacking is lack of discipline. Christians are not disciplined anymore. And so what happens is that, sarah, sarah, we take the grace of God for granted. We don't have any more structure or no more time or no more time to seek the Lord. But a diligent person prepares himself before the opportunity comes. A diligent person gets himself ready. So having said that, let's look now at the diligence, what God said. Giving all diligence. In other words, when you prepared your heart, when you prepared yourself, when you've cleaned, when you made yourself ready. Now, I like that word ready, yeah? Because friends, you know what, yeah? If you are going to go to Nadi tomorrow, yeah? And you are going to go with Fiji Airways, yeah? And you go to the airfield in Nasuri, yeah? And the flight is about 10 o'clock. And you arrive there at 10:30. Do you know what happens? The flight leave without you. They're not going to wait for you. They won't say what? No, they don't care. You 10 o'clock, they're gone, yeah? So before you go, you wake up at 8 o'clock, yeah? Yeah? You get yourself ready. You polish your shoes. You put your hat on. And you drive to the airport. And you wait 2 hours or 3 hours for the plane to come. Why are you doing that? You don't want to miss your flight to Nadi. So what I'm saying is that God is saying to us that we as believers, we're going to prepare our heart. Yeah. We're going to be ready for what God wants. Hallelujah. He wants to do something well in our life. But we have to be diligent enough to get ourselves disciplined. Amen. So tell him, I say, neighbor, you got to be disciplined. Amen. So he said, give me no diligence, add to your faith. You know, friend, our faith is not a stagnant faith. Our faith is not a faith that you sit down and you say, oh, no, no, no. It's a moving faith. It's continuous. In other words, it's every day, every hour. Something is on. So the Bible said, add to your faith. Amen. Wow. Wow. So certain things you got to do. It takes a diligent person to add. It takes a diligent person to wake up in the morning and to say, I'm going to prepare for what God wants to do. A lazy person does not add to your faith. A lazy person sleeps, and when the alarm comes to pray, oh, I'll sleep another 1 hour. Yeah, you know? And they keep going and going, and they don't have, oh, when they wake up, oh, good, let me run. I'm already late. Because we've lacked diligence. We've lacked discipline. But a diligent person knows that God is about to do something new. Hallelujah. A diligent person knows that the move of God is powerful. A diligent person knows that God wants to show his power and his anointing and his glory and his grace. The man will remove every obstacle and say, God, here I am this moment. Hallelujah. A diligent person is ready for the move of God. So here in Sawani, it is our time to be diligent. You know, some of you here today have been Christian for a long time. But when you are stagnant, are you moving nowhere? When you are stagnant, are you not going anywhere? You're not doing things for God. Can I tell you something, friends? This afternoon, yeah? We came here. We went all these houses. Everywhere. I can tell you the people that live here, JW live there, and all. We want to preach to them all. Pastor Vanicky is with us. The wife. You know what, friends? You know, for us it's a joy. But you live here. You are here. There are people in your street. There are people in your environment, in your working place. All you got to do is remember that if that person in your working place, if that man in your working place doesn't know Jesus, if he dies right now, he's going to hell. So when you have that consciousness, when you know that, you preach the gospel, you tell the people at work, you don't be scared. You don't be shy. Because you are diligent in what God has given to you. You don't be scared. You don't look around. You don't bother who cares. You don't bother if people like you. You don't bother if they don't want to. You don't bother if they care about you. What you care about is to do the work of the master. Is to do the work of your father. Because because you are so diligent, you are adding to your faith. You know what I come to realize about Christianity?
Amen.
It's a level you go. The more you go, the sweeter it becomes. The more you go, the more you go higher and higher and higher and higher. You know, some Christians complain, oh, we stay too long at church. When you go higher, you don't even care about the time you spend. When you go higher, you don't care about the fasting and prayer. You don't care about the money you spend. You don't care about it because you know what? You are going higher and higher and higher and higher. That is what the Bible says. Add to your faith. Virtue. Add to your faith. Something else. What are the additions? They are all in the Bible there, yeah? Add to your faith this one. Add to your faith that one. Friends, the most important thing tonight in Fiji here is that God is calling my sister there, my brother there, all of us here to rise up.
Hallelujah.
To rise up in Fiji.
Hallelujah.
We have been sleeping too long. To rise up and tell the people of Fiji that Jesus Christ, He is Lord. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Tell the people of Fiji that our message. You know, the man was asking me this moment. He was trying to say a lot of things about JW. And I said to him, friend, we have a very simple message. We've not come to complicate things. It's a very simple message.
That's
our
right.
Message is this. Jesus came to die and set you free. Is it?
Yeah.
That's all. That's all. Everything we talk about is all in that. That if you accept Him right now, you will be delivered of your sin. That's all the message. That's all. Hallelujah. So you and I, we carry the message. You and I, Junior carried the message. You and I, we carry a very powerful message. And so the diligent man will begin to remember right now and say, I will add to my faith. We add to my faith virtue. I will add to virtue knowledge. I will come to know God more. I will come to understand what God wants from my life. I will come to understand what God is telling me about. I will come to understand what the plan and purpose of God is. I will come to understand that God loves me so much. I will come to understand that as I study Him, as I come into a closer contact with the Lord, as I understand His move in my life, as I walk in faith, as I walk in power, I'm adding to my faith something else. There is a knowledge coming in. I'm knowing God more and more and more. I am standing on the word of God. There is no witchcraft. Hallelujah. There is no devil. Hallelujah. There is no demon. Hallelujah. That will take me away from my God. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
I am standing firm. I am declaring the glory of God. I am marching on from glory to glory. I am standing upon the word of my God. Why somebody shall amen? A diligent person gets the knowledge. Gets the knowledge. He knows what God said about him. He knows that God said, flee youthful lust. He knows that God says that adultery is a sin. He knows that God says that we are living the last days. You know, many people don't even know we are living the last days. Many people are busy building mansions,
yes,
occupying country, which is good to have a house, no problem. But the reality is that you got to remember that we are living in the last days.
Mm-hmm.
You got to remember that God is only not a fault to know His plan for love. You know what the Bible says? Bible says, at the time of ignorance, God overlooked. But now, He commands every man, everywhere to repent. In other words, ignorance is not an excuse for your for where you are living. You cannot say, I don't know. No, because God right now is asking you to be diligent.
Mm-hmm.
Get the Bible.
Mm.
You know, we used to have quiet time. When we woke up in the morning, we gather the whole family together. We have quiet time. Our kids know the Bible. Our kids know everything. Today, our kids are all occupied with iPad and iPhone and mobile and all. They forget the Bible. My brother, my sister, a diligent person gets the knowledge again back into his home, into his family. A diligent person begins to say again, I want my family to know God more. My brother, my sister, the greatest heritage you can give to your children is not your house, it's not your car. The greatest heritage is that they know the Lord Jesus as their Lord and Savior. The greatest heritage is that you stand firm and let them know the God that you are serving. The greatest heritage is that you are able to lead them from here to here and allow God's power in your life.
Amen.
That's the greatest heritage.
Amen.
But if you don't know that,
hallelujah,
what happens is that we dance around. And let's continue. He says, and to knowledge, what they say, and to knowledge, temperance, and to temperance, patience. And to patience, he said what? Godliness. You know, friend, let me talk about temperance, patience, and godliness. You know, friends, yeah? When you become a Christian, there is a real propensity for you and I to soar higher.
Jesus.
Friends, some of us are still living our Christian life in the flesh. Some of us are still living our Christian life, and some of us are still allowing the work of the flesh to take over our life. Mm. So because of that, we are not patient. Because of that, we don't have a temperance. And because of that, we mess up a lot of things. God is taking us somewhere. We are too much in a hurry to say, God, where am I going? We are too much in a hurry to say, God, where am I going? Because you know what? We have not allowed patience to reign in our heart. We have not allowed patience to dwell in our heart. We have not allowed patience to be our soul. So the Bible says, add to your faith, temperance, patience, and godliness. I love it when God says godliness. You have to add godliness to yourself. You know what, friends? Please listen to me now. The Lord gave me a message. The Lord gave me a word. It says, the unsaved pastor. The pastor that is not born again. Hey! In other words, there are pastors that are not born again. How can it be that a man that stands in the pulpit on a Sunday to tell you about God doesn't know God himself? Hey! How can it be that a man that leads worship on a Sunday doesn't even know that God is leading? How can it be? So what happens? The blind man leads the blind. What do they do? They fall into a ditch. You say, but pastor, I can see him singing. I can see him with all the nice car. Frank, can I tell you something? When you come to the house of God, when the man of God mounts a pulpit and tells you the word of God, if the word of God doesn't cut your heart and discern your thoughts and make you to repent and serve before God, something is either wrong with the message or the messenger. Mm-hmm. And when I know my God, His word is clear. The message is powerful. The message is designed. So friends, God said godliness. Is it possible that there are people in the house of God that are not godly? Is it possible that there are people who are sitting with us in the house of God that are not godly? Hey, is it possible that there are people who shake hands with us? That there are people who laugh with us, who have communion with us, that are not godly? Is it possible? Yes, it is possible. Because I'm going to tell you something now, yeah? How come there's so much divorce in the house of God? We've allowed ungodliness into our hearts. I've been in Fiji many, many times. And one of the things I see here is the rate of divorce is very high. Very high. Every second person I meet, I'm divorced. I'm divorced. But I go to church. Where's your husband? Oh, you ran away. I'm with another man. And so on and so forth. Yeah. You know what I say? Yeah. When I see that, it shows me the state of the Christian heart. Mm. It shows me the heart of men. Because, friends, if you are godly, if you have a godly heart, you will stand and fight for your family and your home and your marriage. And you will stand firm and declare the power of God and the glory of God and say, God, I'm going to love my wife more. I'm going to love my husband more. I'm going to declare more. I don't care what anybody says. But because I am godly, I'm godly.
Amen.
I will stand firm. I will let my whole neighbor know that this is the wife or this is my husband.
Yes.
I will not divorce. I will not run around with another woman or another man. I will stand firm because you know what? I'm godly. And that is the problem today. Many, many people in the house of God no longer have godliness. They don't have the fear of God. They don't have the fear to serve God. They don't have the unction. They don't have the desire. They don't have the fear. In fact, there is so much ungodliness in some churches that if God was to die, some churches will not even know it. Can I repeat that again? If God, was to die, some churches will not even know it. So what am I saying to that? Add to your faith, godliness. Add to godliness, brotherly kindness. Add to brotherly kindness, charity. All these are the things that God wants us to add to our faith. Now, this is what I want to say tonight to you. You know what? If you are here tonight and you've not allowed the Spirit of God to break you and to mold you and to work in your life and to break every power of darkness or every worldliness, the time has come for you, people of Fiji, to arise. The time has come for you to say, my God, my God, my God, I'm going to live my life now. I'm going to add to my faith every godliness, every brotherly kindness, every charity. I'm going to press on for the kingdom of God. I will not let anybody stop me. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Say amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And God is calling us now to a new standard. A standard.
Hallelujah.
Higher. Higher. Mm. Higher. Mm. My brother, my sister, we love you all so much. That's why we come with a message that God has put in our heart.
Hallelujah.
I haven't come to tell you how many books I wrote or how many cars I have got. No, I haven't come to tell you to buy my books, or I haven't come to tell you to give me money. I haven't come to tell you anything. I don't care about your money. I don't care about your goods. I don't care about nothing you have. What I care about is your soul.
Right.
And when you leave this earth, you go to the kingdom of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. 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 So people of God, that is a challenge for you tonight. And you are here tonight, and you are saying, God, God, there are things holding me back. I want to press on right now. Because you know what I come to find out?
Amen.
So many of us are in the cage. You know, in prison, yeah? The prisoners, we saw some of them when we were coming. They let some of them out to mow the lawn, yeah? They wore an orange uniform. But I want to tell you something, yeah? The prisoners in the prison sometimes are better than the prisoners outside.
Amen.
You say, what? Yeah. Some people are in prison to alcohol. Hey. Some are in prison to alcohol. Every time there's a bottle, go. Every time there's zinc, they can't stop. They are bound by alcohol. They may be walking in the street, but they're in prison. They may be laughing, but they're in prison. Unless they come before the Lord Jesus Christ and say, God, I repent. And let God pray that I teach you in the name of Jesus Christ. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
To sexuality. Some are in prison. I said it many times about sexy. Some men are in prison to sex or to women. Every woman that wears a skirt, they run up and down for. Oh, everything because they're in prison. Every time their eyes are rolling the hole, they are driving, and everyone they pass, they turn and their neck is gonna break. You know why? Because they're in prison for that spirit.
That's right.
Some women too, they're in prison. And that is why God is saying to us, come out of the prison. Let me deliver you.
Amen.
Let me help you.
Amen.
Let me set you free.
Hallelujah.
Let me change your life.
Amen.
Let me come and make something for you.
Hallelujah.
Right now, hallelujah. Add to your faith. You know, people of God, God is saying to us right now that the days of ignorance are over. The days of playing around are over. That these days in Fiji Island, in Suwannee, that God is calling my sister there, my brother there, all of us here. God is saying to us, arise and let me see the glory of God all over you. Hallelujah. And God is saying to you, when you arise, I will pour my spirit.
Oh, hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I will pour my spirit.
Yes,
I will pour my anointing. I will pour my glory.
Hallelujah.
I will pour my fire. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I will release again.
Hallelujah.
I will touch you again. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I will bring you out. Hallelujah. I will show myself stronger.
Hallelujah.
I will do a mighty work in your life. But today is your day.
Hallelujah.
It's your day. It's your day. Let me finish. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's your day. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, yeah. And then it says that, for if these things be in you, look at me now, hallelujah. If these things be in you. Now, people, hey, this is important. It says, and abound.
Yes, yes.
They make you that you shall neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Now, look at me. Hallelujah. This is where it's coming to right now. Hallelujah. There are many believers that are barren. They are unfruitful in their knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. Some believers, you got to ring a green. Are you coming to church today? Oh, I don't really know. I see how the weather goes. Maybe if I have a car, maybe if you come and take me. Well, don't worry. I will call you last minute. Yeah, that's how people are. Some people, pastor will call me. So what am I saying? Their dedication to God is this little. They're not fruitful. They've not caught the vision yet. They've not caught the reality yet. The Bible says, if these things be in you and abound, in other words, overflowing, your knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ shall be what stronger, it shall be what breaker, it shall be more fruitful. In other words, God wants you to be fruitful in your knowledge. What am I saying, friends? You know, when you get married, yeah, after 1 year, 2 years, or so, 1.5 years, yeah, everybody begin to expect something. You know what I mean? Yeah. Anybody know, yeah? They begin to expect the fruit from the marriage, yeah? It's a cultural thing. Many men, after 2 years, if there's no fruit, they will ask you, is
there anything wrong? Yeah, yeah, amen, yeah. Then we ask, you know what? Because everybody wants to see the fruit of your marriage, which is a child, obviously, yeah? What am I saying right now? The fruit of your Christian life, after 2 months, after 3 months, after 4 months, after 1 year, if you know bearing fruit, something is wrong somewhere. And that is what the Bible says. If this thing be in you and abound, it shall make you to bear fruits. Today, you see, Pastor, what's my fruit? The people that you've preached to, how many of you here can say, when I was coming to church last Sunday or last Tuesday, my neighbor was outside watering the lawn. I went to my neighbor and I said, Bully, I want to talk to you about Jesus. I went and I said, Vinod, I want to talk to you about Jesus. How many of you can say that when I went, Vinod gave his life to Jesus Christ? Oh, I was so on fire for God. But you know what happened? The devil has made us to shut our mouths. We're so scared to talk. We're so scared. We don't want to tell them. And that is why the world is going to hell. So friends, lift your hand and say, Father, I want to bear fruit. Come on. Say, Father, I want to bear fruit. Hallelujah. Now, this is your challenge right now. Those who are listening far back, I want to tell you something right now, yeah? Your fruit is not only your maturity and your Christian life, but let us see how many people you've ministered to, how many people you pray for. You know, we have a tendency here, yeah, to say, oh, pastor, we pray for you. Yeah, it's good. But I want to tell you something. You pray for people as well. Not only the pastors, not only the minister, you, housewife. You can lay hands on the sick. Hey, nobody said hallelujah. Amen. Hey, somebody say amen, hallelujah. Amen. You can cast out devils, hallelujah, amen. Hallelujah. That's a fruit, hallelujah. You can declare. If I'm friend, you don't have to wait for your pastor to pray for the sick.
That's right.
Nobody is hearing me, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Behold, I give unto you what? Power and what? Authority.
Yes.
He said, you go and lay hands on the sick.
Yes.
Bear fruit.
Yes.
You're in the mall. You're in New World Mall, yeah? That Vinod Patel bought, yeah? And you knew one more, Vinod Patel comes in. And he said, I have a headache. Hey, Vinod, like, I'm going to pray for you. Oh, he's a rich man. So what? The Bible says, watch any prophet a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul.
That's
pray for Vinod. Pray for all the new world people. And let God manifest his power. My brother and sister, these are the days in Fiji. We can't be quiet. Oh, I love it.
Oh,
hallelujah. In the name of Jesus Christ, you're going to arise, my brother. You're going to be a fool in the kingdom of God.
Hallelujah.
You know what I see? I see some of us living the life of our forefathers. Oh, tradition has destroyed us. We've allowed tradition. We've missed it with Christianity. Oh, I can drink a little bit of kava. Kava is good for your health. Oh, I drink kava so that I can be like this. Kava will make you stumble to hell. Yeah? Yeah, kava has no good for you, yeah? Oh, well, you know, I can drink dry gin, yeah? Friends, where is it in the Bible? Oh, well, you know what? I can have 4 wives. Where is it in the Bible? You know what, friends? This is why Jesus said, because of the traditions of your elders, you make void the word of God. That's happening here.
Yeah.
You've allowed tradition to take over the... No! It is time to come out. Somebody say, I'm coming out. Come on, come on, come on. Say, I'm coming out. Hallelujah. Come on, say, I'm coming out. Say, I'm coming out. Hallelujah. At this moment, God is saying to you, if these things be in you, you shall abound.
Amen.
You know why I love the Lord so much? Because the word of God is very simple. Very, very simple. We don't need to complicate it. Take English as it is. Take the word as it is. If these things be in you, everything we talk about today, and abound, you will never be barren in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. So this evening, as we are gathered here in the island, in the island of Sewane, and we are all talking and listening, and we are all bred our family, because I love it when families come together. It doesn't matter whether you are young or old or baby, whatever you are, it doesn't matter right now, but we are family. Eh? But so because of that, I can talk to you heart to heart. I can tell you that if these things be in you, the reality is now, Lord, I want to abound. I want to grow in the knowledge of my Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let me close this message. Hallelujah. And the Bible says here, wherefore, brethren, give diligence to make your calling and your election sure. In other words, yeah, the time again comes, diligence again. But he said, but he that lacketh these things is what? is what? Blind. Blind. You know what the blind man does, yeah? When you are blind,
stumble.
You can't see where you're going, yeah? I don't want to be like that. I want to see where I'm going. I want to follow the Lord. I don't want to be walking blindly. I want to see where I'm going. So right now, in this place, it is decision time. Somebody say decision. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Maybe you are here. You have never really surrendered your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. Maybe you are here. You've allowed the tradition of the Fijian culture from 1954 to occupy your life. Maybe the church you used to go before, they don't believe in evangelism. They don't believe in laying hands on the sick. Yeah, there are people that are here. They don't believe in laying hands on the sick. Maybe your church doesn't believe that a woman can be an evangelist. Maybe they don't believe a woman can. But you know what? This is amazing to you. A woman cannot be an evangelist, but the woman can go and make money and bring money home. So what am I saying right now? Yeah, we all should do the work of God. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah, nobody say amen. Hallelujah. So God is saying to you right now, let us break free from our tradition. Let us come out of our tradition.
Amen.
You may say, I'm only a housewife. Yes, God will use housewives too. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm only a student. Yes, God will use a student too. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I don't have a job. Yes, God will use people that don't have a job too. So this moment is the moment of decision. We're going to rise today. We're going to pray today. Hallelujah. Stand on your feet. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In this is being. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If this is being you. Hallelujah. If this thing be in you, hallelujah. If this thing be in you, it shall make you to grow in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. If this thing be in you, right now is your time, hallelujah. Here in Fiji, it's your time now, hallelujah. I'm going to open the floor right now, hallelujah. I'm going to ask you right now, you have been sitting for a while, yeah? It is now time for a decision. My brother, please look at me. Nobody close your eyes, yes, yeah? You know, God doesn't make mistakes. Yeah, hallelujah. When we came here this afternoon, we came by divine call. Nobody told us to come. God said, go. We just went.
Yes.
We didn't have any plan. We didn't have any program. We just came. And God began to deliver people. People were walking out of there. People, a man we met here was instantly healed. Many of them healed. The woman, people we pray for today, people gave their life to Christ. What am I saying? Because today we want to challenge you that you and I, we can lift our hands together and do more for God. Come on, close your eyes. Hallelujah. We're going to play a song right now. Hallelujah. Come on. Hallelujah. Come on.